Let's talk about the question, is Mohammed the Comforter? Well, to begin with, how do we know about the Comforter? Well, because Jesus told us about the Comforter. Where did Jesus tell us this? Well, in several places, in John 14, verses 15 through 17, John chapter 14, verse 26, John chapter 15, verse 26, and John 16, verse 7 through 15. In this video, let's carefully examine John 14, 15 through 17. What does John 14, 15 through 17 say? If you love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But you know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. If you love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you. So, who is Jesus talking to? When he says, he shall give you, who is he speaking to? He's speaking to the disciples. So the Comforter is first of all promised to the disciples, to the people that Jesus was speaking to. When exactly did the disciples live? Well, they were alive at Jesus' time. When he said, the Father shall give to you, he was talking to the disciples. When do you think the disciples would need the Comforter? How about during their lifetime? Would Jesus send the Comforter after they were dead? Would that make sense? Actually, it would be quite useless. So Jesus promised the Comforter to who? To the disciples. When? During their lives. And when did Mohammed come along? 600 years later, that he may abide with you forever. The Comforter would live with them. Abide with them means to live, to make a home with. Live with the disciples. Again, who is Jesus speaking to? He shall give you, the disciples, another Comforter, that he may abide with you, the disciples. And when did Mohammed come? 600 years later, long after they were dead. So could Mohammed live with them? Because Jesus promised the Comforter would abide with them forever. Could Mohammed live with them? Absolutely not. Could Mohammed comfort them? Absolutely not. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not. So the Comforter would be the Spirit of truth. Okay, that I can see that sort of might be ambiguous in some people's minds. But could the world receive Mohammed? Yes, they could. Did the world receive Mohammed? Yes, they did. Could the world see Mohammed? Yes, they could, because, well, he was not invisible. Could Mohammed be the Comforter? Absolutely not. Because it says, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not. It can't see him, neither knoweth him. But you know him. Wait a minute. Who is Jesus talking to? He's talking to the disciples. But you know him. That means the disciples already knew the Spirit of truth. They already knew the Comforter. But you know him. Present tense, you know him. You, the disciples, know the Comforter. You already know the Comforter. Think about this. You already know the Comforter. Did the disciples know Muhammad? No, they did not. Jesus said, they know the Comforter. Did the disciples know Muhammad? No, they did not. And what did Jesus say again? But you know him. But you know him. Think about that. Jesus said of the Comforter, but you know him. Past tense. The disciples already knew the Comforter. This is really important. Pay attention. Again, did the disciples know Muhammad? No, they did not. So could Muhammad be the Comforter? Absolutely not. But you know him, for he dwelleth with you. For he dwelleth with you. Again, Jesus says, the disciples already knew the Comforter. Jesus said, for he dwelleth with you. Did Muhammad even exist during the lives of the disciples? No. Jesus said, the Comforter already lived with them. So could Muhammad be the Comforter? Well, did Muhammad already live with the disciples? Be honest. Be objective. Think about this. Did Muhammad already live with the disciples? No, he did not. So could Muhammad be the Comforter? No, he could not. And shall be in you, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. Shall be, that means he's not yet in you. He will be in you. He shall be in you. Jesus did not say, the words of the Comforter shall be in you. He said, you know him, and he shall be in you. Could Muhammad be in them? Absolutely not. Jesus is talking to the disciples. He says, the Comforter will come to you and will live in you, and you already know him. Muhammad didn't come for 600 years later. It makes no sense. But I do sense a common theme here. Could Muhammad be the Comforter? No, he could not. He simply doesn't fit the description. Let's review. Muhammad could not abide forever. Muhammad did not live with the disciples. Muhammad could not live with the disciples because he was not alive. The disciples did not know Muhammad. Muhammad could never be in the disciples, not even his words. So again, we must ask ourselves, honestly, could Muhammad be the Comforter of John 14, verses 15 through 17? No, he could not. If you call yourself Muslim, think about it. Muhammad simply does not fit the description which Jesus gave. This means Muhammad cannot possibly be the Comforter Jesus spoke of in John 14, verses 15 through 17. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.